I try, at least to answer your question, I try to put up all the streams, but sometimes, as it is with working life, sometimes you just come up with bad ideas or stuff that just doesn't work out and things like that. And sometimes the stream is just not worth going online. So yeah. So change the settings there to less of the tree mic. Still not happy with the sound I have in mind. Let's try the different close mic there and get rid of the tree mic in total for a moment. I really want a bone dry sound. We'll try that out. So let's get rid of this. Try close off. Obviously, a little bit to the right. Need to fix that here. A little notch to the left. And the violin a little more to the left. And the cello, close three off, close one off, and to the right. So, see how that sounds. So violin one obviously needs to be a little bit louder on this mic. Let's check this out. And now let's add some room on our own. What do we go? Well, let's go with a Mexican chamber. Let's go medium chamber two. And since we were talking about this, having multiple tracks at once, so I'm going into the sense here, then to the chamber. Put them on and bring them in and see how it sounds. So, I think the close two position of the strings works better than the close one. That might be due to the fact I think close one has more baked in reverb, it seems. If you just compare, for example, the cello, the short notes here. That was violin, not the cello. There's still a lot of reverb in that close sound. It's, well, it's closer and not that much tail. plugins you prefer from Slate. I love the Virtual Console Collection. It works great and wonders. Actually, I might apply that here already. And putting that on master as well, but this time going for the mix bus. What happens when we actually make them bigger? With the exposed spiccato. So using Spitfire. Well, I have a bunch of Spitfire stuff. Just got me Sable a while ago. So they make definitely great stuff. We'll cover that sometime later. So let's bring that. Shine. Don't think I need to thicken up the cellos here. I mean, obviously it's not primarily designed as a chamber string or a string quartet library. It's the first chairs for the orchestra section, so I think it sounds pretty great as an quartet. Let's stick with the something here. And that actually 16th triplets. Let's bring that down. A little bit and make it less jumpy. Ah, that was just the the legato articulation there. Actually, I can change that back since we didn't go for the fake round robin. Let's put the full patch. Load this. A little bit to the right. So, let's go with that's way too much there. Legato, please. This is soft sustain. Okay, dying. Let's delete this. As I've said, just a little bit of fumbling around with the library, and let's try to come up with something more nice and fluent. Let's go a little bit down. That might be nicer. Mm-hmm. Damn it, if I actually could play. Oh, wow. Just trying out things here. This is damn it. Let's try this. Go with a soft sustain patch. Actually, I wanna make use of niente, so actually fade the mod width to zero. Not reverb on the master. Actually sounded pretty nice. Well, let's hear it without the piano. Damn it. Let's double the violin one there. Definitely interesting how much it changes the sound with the microphone positions. Too much. Let's bring them out again. Definitely need some fumbling around more with the microphone positions there. This is everything far from perfect. Oh God. change that to starting out with legato, and last note can actually be, let's go to sustained attack. Use the time there. Knows what this is good for. Actually go with a portato as legato. No, they actually don't have any vibrato control. Last part was shit, so once more. Thank you. like the second part, so let's just take the portato just for the first part. To portato long here, and I make that one legato as well. I want to change the pace here. Double the violin line here. Thank you. something like that. Double the first violin line and see if we can actually do some harmony voicings there. Just playing around here with a lead line, playing something in between. Let's see. This is actually full range, so really, really soft to pretty loud. I wouldn't say triple F, but a good forte, definitely. Let's see. I actually let loop this for a moment and take a short break there and see. So this is what we have so far, playing, fiddling around a little bit, haha, pun intended, with First Chairs Orchestra Tool, the Berlin Strings. Not like this. So please, pretty please, make this legato and just give them a little bit of a nudge to the correct position. This is legato as well. This is soft, I guess, and this is legato as well. So, should be like this. Thank you. Actually, it didn't change the articulation here. To spiccato. Right, so once more. This should be portato short. What times do you usually work? Sorry for this. Well, pretty much when inspiration strikes, but I usually work at night, or I'm more creative at night. Change this guy to let's see how that sounds. Off to Nirvana. So, okay, change back to legato there. That's a short break here. This guy actually needs to be there. Cello here to not to spiccato but to staccato. So coming from here. And back to spiccato. This bugs me a little bit here. Don't like the sound there. Okay, let's do a little bit of quantization here on these guys. A little bit far off the grid. For these as well, just a little bit. Down a little bit, and actually that was better here. Seems there's two round robins there. These guys a little bit. Let's try this. Bring these back in and see again. There is one gun missing. But not least, this note could actually be a portado. So let's bring that guy there and use the short portado long. So, okay, let's get it back together. Thank you. was nice. What was that? So far, I think that sounds pretty nice. Cleaning up a little bit. Let's change for the cello to take over the lead here. I think that might be a nice idea. Solo for the viola. There. Actually, I think we change in between to the violins. So once more. That might be nice. On the last one, change back to soft sustains. That later. Oh, that was this. Thank you. Well, that might work. Still thinking what might be. Trying out. Thank you. Sounds like this. Wait. Go for a leg out of here. Let's just have them a pause at that point. Damn cycle. This is actually staccato. So, I was more talkative last session. Well, it was not 2 a.m. in the night last session, I guess. No, just kidding. Strings all together on their own. Germany, exactly. That's where I am. Well, let's bring it to an end here. I actually like the chord progression there. So let's put that actually on. Modulation, please. So, let's see once more what we have all in all. So, actually, let's thicken up the last part. With the basses from Berlin Strings. And actually, I really want to have them soft. So I'm going to take the sul tasto legato. I'm actually using SSDs, I just need to resave the patches from my Berlin Strings. So that's why it's taking a little bit longer. So, first let's lay down these spaces. I think my battery just died. Okay, I'm gonna fix that for a second. It seems to work now. Oh, actually you need to have the window active. Cycle. Yeah, using Touch OC when needed. So, let's check these strings once more. So, let's give it a little bit of sparkle. So let's put these into a group. Let's see whether they need some EQ or not. So actually just a little bit of a odd frequency here that I'm going to push out a little bit. little bit of... Actually, for the shine, I'm going to delete this one. Strings as well. Actually, EQ a little bit of the high end to make it a little bit darker. Change the last part of these staccato notes here. Just putting a gentle touch where do we have it? Maybe C rack on the master channel. Keep it unprocessed. A little bit of ozone. Starting with a preset here. What can we do here? Checking, checking, checking. Actually, let's just get rid of that one. Let's just check the sounds. There is something in the higher mid range that bugs me a little bit from the string sound. I may try to tame that a little bit. Let's try the multiband. Should be something around here.
Thank you.
So last but not least, secret weapon. Don't overdo it. That should be good enough. I mean, it's very sparsely orchestrated, so just the quartet and a piano, so you don't get that big sound out of the stereo bus like with the full production. And actually, you want to keep some dynamics, so I think I even bring that down a little bit. Actually, I just want to get it up to volume. It brings out a little bit of the tape effect from Isotope. That tends to get a little, let's try to round it out a little bit more. And last but not least, we can still increase the overall volume a little bit by bringing in this little guy and just giving it a little dip upwards. 1 dB or something, should be fine. Thank you. think this actually sounds pretty nice. Last thing to do, I guess, is tweak a little bit more of the chamber sound. And push a little bit together. Let's see how that sounds with a random hall. Let's go random hall. Let's go with. Sorry, I think the piano still needs a little bit of compression. It jumps too far around, in my opinion. So there was one preset that I really loved on piano. That's in the SSL bus, and that is the Lily White piano. Mistake there. So. Not necessarily. When I work, for example, I don't have an external reverb for the piano. I use the built-in one because it just sounds great. So it always depends on what instruments I use and if I want to put them into a coherent space or if it works. I mean, you could always go on and tweak and tweak and tweak, but I think overall the sound is pretty cool. I love the tone of the Berlin strings, to be honest, and I think they complement the Berlin strings full library really, really nicely. I didn't do that today to enhance the string section and actually make it more distinct or give it a little bit more edge with the first chairs. That's what they can do as well. But they really work well for a quartet setup. Really, really like the tone. So yeah, that's what we did today. Berlin strings, first chairs, hands on. Hope you liked it and enjoy the track in its final version, and hopefully see you next time. Thanks for watching. As usual, remember that you can subscribe on Facebook or on YouTube to get all the necessary infos, and obviously you can also donate for the channel. And yeah, enjoy the track and see you next time.